So when we want to make the trot smaller and you feel that he's going to quit, you don't do more all the time, but instead you do less. He feels like he gets wobbly from behind. At that time, you give him a little insistence with two legs, with a stick, whatever, ba-boom, come on. But your body language is still riding for the small gait. So in other words, we're just asking him on his own to do more like this instead of like that, and more up and down and less over the ground. So we bring him to that more over the ground feeling in the trot, or more a little bit up and down feeling in the trot. When you feel like he's quitting and he's no longer carrying you, at that time right away you, hey, hey, wake up. But then right away you're gonna stretch yourself. You're gonna ride like it worked, and you're gonna strive very hard not to be driving him over the ground out, because that's when you get that short long feeling. The short long comes from him not feeling that up and down and taking responsibility for his own steps. So we need to know right here and now, is he enough in front of us that when we add to this walk a leg yield, we're still gonna have a nice four beat energetic working walk that's round. If it's not feeling like he's doing it well on his own here, then adding leg yield to it is not gonna make anything better. Good. And flexing him to the outside and moving the hind legs to the inside. And we ask him to commit to flexing to the right, to turning to the right. Good. And then we fill the left rein up with the right leg, not with the reins wiggling everywhere, but with the right leg. Come. And leg. And leg. Good. And let him finish each step. This is great. Well done. Well done. Well done. Good. That was perfect. So in the beginning, because he was being a little bit lazy, then you're rushing him slightly off his feet. And then he didn't finish the step in a really healthy way. So then at the end, you had a super walk.